Hi, kindergartners. This is Mrs. Miller with Lesson 4 of Social Studies. Today, we will be talking about a very exciting topic, birthday celebrations. Did you know that birthdays are celebrated in different ways around the world? Well, it's true, they are. Around the world, there are different customs or traditions, different things that people do to celebrate birthdays. So let's hear about some of them. Birthday customs. All around the world, people have special ways to celebrate birthdays. In Japan, children wear new clothes on their birthdays. Breakfast in bed is a fun way to start a birthday in Sweden. Ooh, I like how they celebrate in Sweden. I could go for breakfast in bed on my birthday.
Birthday food.
Birthday food. People eat special foods on their birthdays. Pancakes with fruit are a birthday treat in the Netherlands. In China, people eat long noodles on their birthdays so they will live a long life. Many people eat birthday cake. Raise your hand if you eat birthday cake on your birthday. Yeah, that's a tradition that we have here in the United States.
Birthday fun.
Birthday fun. Many people play birthday games. In Mexico, children break open piñatas on their birthdays. They catch the candy that falls out. Raise your hand if you've ever had a piñata. Yeah, so that's actually a custom or a tradition that comes from Mexico that we've brought here to the United States. It's so much fun, isn't it? In Russia, children at birthday parties cut prizes down from a clothesline. That sounds fun.
Birthday presents.
Birthday presents. People open gifts on their birthdays. In Denmark, presents are left around the birthday child's bed. In some countries, the birthday boy or girl gives presents to guests.
Birthday luck.
Birthday luck. Some birthday customs are for good luck. In Ireland, the birthday child is held upside down and bumped on the floor for good luck. Can you imagine doing that? In Nepal, rice yogurt is put on the birthday child's forehead. Wow, it is so interesting how there are different customs around the world to celebrate birthdays. Can you name two new customs that you just learned about from around the world that show how different cultures, different people celebrate birthdays? Go ahead and share. Ready, set, go. Share them across your fingers. Two different customs. Stop, look, and listen. So here are the two that I came up with. This one that we just learned about. In Ireland, if it's your birthday, if you're the birthday child, you're hung upside down by your feet, like this boy, and your head is bumped on the floor for good luck. And then another birthday custom that I learned about was in China, how they eat long noodles, which is supposed to give you a long life. Now we're going to read this book written by Eve Bunting. It's called Flower Garden, and it's illustrated by Catherine Hewitt. Before we read the book, let's take a picture walk and just start to think about the types of things that might happen in this book. So let's see. Oh, we see a little girl with a shopping cart, and she has lots of flowers in her shopping cart. She's checking out at the grocery store. Then she's walking with her flowers. Now she's on the bus. She's going upstairs. She is sitting down with her flowers. Oh, now she's planting the flowers in pots. Oh, look at all of these beautiful flowers, my goodness. It looks like they put the flowers in a window box. Here are those beautiful flowers. And as people walk by their apartment, they look up at these beautiful flowers. And the little girl looks down. Look, they're lighting candles on a birthday cake. It must be somebody's birthday. Oh, is this her mom? Maybe it's her mom's birthday. Okay, I wonder if she bought those flowers for her mom for her birthday. What do you think? Well, we have to read to find out. So right here on the dedication page, we see a shopping cart. I'm wondering if the girl is going to buy flowers at the shopping cart, at the grocery store. Have you ever seen flowers being sold at a grocery store? Give me a thumbs up if you have. Yes, most grocery stores do sell flowers. Let's read. Garden in a shopping cart. Doesn't it look great? Oh, so they are in a supermarket. I wonder if the little girl gets the flowers at the supermarket. It seems like she is getting them at the supermarket, right? Because she put them in her cart. So my prediction was correct. Now, what do you think the girl will do next? What might happen? Just think. Make a prediction about what might happen next. Garden on the checkout stand. I can hardly wait. I wonder what a checkout stand is. Maybe I can use the picture to help me. I see all the stuff from their cart on the counter, and I see a cash register. Oh, when I'm at the store and it's time to pay, that's what I do. I put everything on the counter for the person to scan. So a checkout stand must be where you pay for your stuff. Garden in a cardboard box, walking to the bus. Garden sitting on our laps. People smile at us. Garden going up the stairs, stopping at each floor. The garden's getting heavier. At last, our own front door. I wonder, is the garden really getting heavier, or do you think the little girl is getting tired from carrying it for so long? Yeah, I think maybe it feels heavier because she's getting tired. Has that ever happened to you? Like you're carrying something, maybe your backpack, and you're walking home from school, and it doesn't feel so heavy when you start out, but then by the end, it feels really heavy because you're starting to get tired. I bet that's what's happening to her. Hurry, hurry, get the trowel, spread the papers thick. Get the bag of potting soil. Get the planting mix. So, what could a trowel be? What do you think? Can you use the picture to help you? Take a look at what she's holding here. Could that be a trowel? Yeah. A trowel is a small shovel to help plant flowers. I wonder why they have to plant the flowers so fast. Do you have any ideas? Why might they have to plant these flowers so fast? Turn and talk to somebody near you. If you're at home, talk to somebody in your house or even your imaginary friend. If you're in school, turn and talk to someone sitting next to you. Ready, set, go. I think they have to plan really fast because it's her mom's birthday and they want to try to surprise her. All right, 1, 2, 3, eyes on me. Let's keep reading to find out why they have to plan so fast. Put purple pansies at each end, daisies white as snow, daffodils, geraniums, and tulips in a row. Garden in a window box high above the street, where butterflies can stop and rest and ladybugs can meet. Walkers walking down below will lift their purple heads and see purple, yellow, red, and white, a color jam. Let me reread that. Walkers walking down below will lift their heads and see purple, yellow, red, and white, a color jamboree. Have you ever heard that word jamboree before? Here it is. Let's read it slow. Stretch it out with me. Jamboree. A little faster. Jamboree. And nice and smooth. Jamboree. So a jamboree is another word for like a party or something festive. And here's the girl looking out of her window, past her window box, at the people looking up at her window at the beautiful flowers. Candles on a birthday cake, chocolate ice cream too. Oh, here's a clue about why they might be hurrying. They are lighting candles on a birthday cake. I wonder whose birthday it is. Does anyone have a guess? Who could this be walking in right here? Okay, turn and talk to the person next to you. Share your guess. Whose birthday do you think it is and what makes you think that? Ready, set, turn and talk. One, two, three, eyes on me. Let's keep reading to find out. Happy, happy birthday, Mom. A garden box for you. Oh, did you guess that it would be her mother? Yeah, that was my guess too. Now, this last page doesn't have any words, but what do you think? Can you make up your own words on this page? What do you think her mom might say to the girl about the flowers? Go ahead and whisper into your hands what you think the mom might say to her. So here's what I thought maybe the mom might say. She might say something like, "Thank you for these beautiful flowers. What a special birthday gift. I love them." Wasn't that a special story? Now, let's see if we can tell the big events, the big things that happen in the story across our fingers. I'm going to go back to the beginning, and I'm just going to flip through the pages. You tell the story across your fingers. Ready, set, go. All right, let's see. Here's how my retell went. I said, a little girl and her dad go to the grocery store and buy flowers for her mom's birthday. They travel home with them, which takes a long time because they have to walk and take a bus and then walk all the way to their apartment, all the way up the stairs. When they get to their apartment, they plant the flowers in a special flower box and put them in the window. Then her mom comes home and they light candles on a birthday cake and sing happy birthday to her. And finally, they give her their very special gift, the flower box. So when is your birthday? Do you know when your birthday is? What month is your birthday in? My birthday is June 8th. My birthday is in the month of June. Do you know when yours is? If you know when your birthday is, call it out in 3, 2, 1. June. That's mine. So, if you are learning in school right now, your teacher is going to make a birthday graph with you. Your teacher is going to find out when your birthday is, and she's going or he's going to color in a bar graph to show all of the birthdays within your class. So for my birthday, which is in June, I would color in this box for June. Now, if you're learning from home, you are going to do a birthday survey. So the birthday survey says, when is your birthday? And you'll click on the month that your birthday is in. Then your teacher will share the results with you. So you'll get to see how many people have a birthday in the same month as you and how many people have birthdays in different months. Then when you're finished, you will get to fill out this very special book, My Birthday Book. I'll go through it with you. It says My Birthday Book by, and then you'll write your name in that blank space. It says my name is, you're going to write your name again. My birthday is, and you'll write the date of your birthday. I am blank years old. You'll write how many years old you are. On my birthday, I, and then I want you to draw a picture. And you could even use some words to tell what you do on your birthday. What are some customs that your family has? Do you always get a birthday cake and light candles and blow them out? Do you sing happy birthday? Do you have a piñata? Do you have a special birthday breakfast? Maybe you have pancakes on your birthday every year. Write down what your birthday custom is. Thank you for learning with me today. Have a great day, everybody.